Sepang. Technical characteristics of Sepang. You know, that track, it's got a little bit of everything. It's got two really fast straights. It's got slow corners and fast corners. But the crazy thing about Sepang is we test there a lot, and it's never the same when we go and race. So you'll get the setup, the rider will come in, bike's up, it's no good. Well, it's the way we tested. And the reason is basically on a test, three-day test, you get the track really good on the third day, you put on some tires, you do a great lap time. You can never do that during the race. You'll get 4 hours of track time. Moto 2, Moto 3 is out there. The track's never as good. So Sepang is really interesting because even though we have a lot of test time, you just can't get it the same as the test. And the riders always kind of go, well, what's wrong with you guys? So anyway, we just got to make sure that we have, even though we have two long straights, you got to come out of turn 14 and turn 15 good to make sure you're going well at the end of those straights. And again, sometimes the rider just wants to go fast on the straight and kind of doesn't want to get the drive. So as long as you got good braking, acceleration out the corner, and geez, good handling, it's got everything. It's got everything we have all throughout MotoGP in that one circuit. So we got to get it right, balance good, get Ben, he's good on the brakes, and see what happens. We have good corner speed. So coming out of T14, T15, it gives us good acceleration down the straights. And then, of course, the Yamaha handles really good. Sometimes we don't have the best top end, but as long as they nail the corners, it's really good.